Recently, I created a slideshow animation for After Effects, and many of you are asking for the same tutorial in DaVinci Resolve. So in this video, I will create an amazing corporate slideshow animation inside of DaVinci Resolve. This video will be approximately 18 minutes long, so watch this video till the end. Hey guys, this is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's open DaVinci Resolve, take a new project and get started. Alright, so this is DaVinci Resolve 18.5, and before we start this video, we have to do some basic setting as usual. So click on the setting button in the corner and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080, which is the full HD resolution. But if you want to create this animation in 4K, you only have to select this option Ultra HD. And then we have to select a frame rate. So in this case, I'm using 60 frames per second for a smooth animation, but you can select 24 or 30 frames per second, whatever you want, and then click on save. Now we have to create a fusion composition because we are going to create this animation in fusion page. So it's very simple and very important. So just go to the media pool, right click on that, click on new fusion composition. This is going to be the slide one. So let's call it slide 01. Duration, make it 6 seconds long, which is good enough for one slide. Frame rate 60 and click on create. Now let's drag and drop the fusion composition on the timeline just like that, and then go to the fusion page. And here we have the media out node, so just drag this media out to the side for now. And we need only one viewer, so click on the single viewer. And now let's start by creating a background. So this is the background icon. Let's drag and drop the background on the flow window and drag and drop to the viewer to get a preview of that. And as you can see, we have a black background, so we have to select a white background. So just go to the inspector window. Here we have the color. Let's change the color to white. And now let's animate the background. So it's very simple again. This is the polygon tool. Let's attach the polygon with this background. And here we have the automatic keyframes. So just right click on this text and click on the remove polygon one polyline. And now we have to create a fresh new animation. But before that, let's create a rectangular shape. Hold control and scroll down to zoom out and hold shift on the keyboard. Let's create a rectangle just like that. And then just go to frame number 60, which is equal to 1 second according to 60 frame per second. But if you have 30 frame or 24 frame per second, then you have to go on frame number 30 or 24 for 1 second. And then just right click on the text, click on animate, or you can also click on the diamond button to add a keyframe. Then just go to very first frame of this animation, highlight these two control points and just drag these control points right over here. And as you can see here, we have a linear animation, but it is not looking good. We have to make it smoother. Just go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen, check this option polyline, click on fit button, highlight both the keyframes, hit S on the keyboard to smooth, or you can also click on this smooth button, hold this handle and just drag it over here and create a nice and smooth graph just like that. And then you can close the spline window. After that, you can see here we have a smooth animation. Now let's import the media files. So just go to the edit page, go to the media pool, right click on that, click on import media. Here we have the media files. You can download these media files from the link given in the description. So we need this noise, stroke and the image, because we have only one slide, so we need only one image. But if you have multiple slides, then you can import multiple photos or image or video, whatever you want, and click on open. Now we have to match the size and the frame rate of these clips according to the project settings. So you can simply drag and drop the image on the timeline just like that. Match the duration of the image or video. Select the image or video, go to inspector window and fit the size of the image. So here we have the zoom. Let's increase the zoom value and fit the image just like that. And now you can right click on this image, click on new fusion clip. You can close the inspector window, select the fusion clip, hit backspace to remove from the timeline, and do the same thing for noise and the stroke. So I'm gonna do this in fast forward. Perfect. And then you can go to the fusion page. Here we have to import the image file first. So just go to the media pool. This is the fusion clip one, which is the image. So let's drag and drop on the flow window. You can close the media pool, drag and drop to the viewer, As you can see, here we have an still image. So select the media, hit F2 to rename. Let's call it image. Hit OK. Now add a transform node with it. Drag and drop the transform to the viewer. Go to the end of this animation. Right click on size, click on animate. And then just go to very first frame of this animation. Here we have to increase the size value. So I'm going to set the value 1.2. And now we have nice and simple zoom out animation. All right. And now let's add one more animation. So just go to frame number 120, which is equal to 2 seconds. Here we have the center. So first of all, just go to very first frame of this animation. Right click on center, click on animate, and then go to the frame number 120. Drag the image on the right hand side. You can set the value 0.65. You can move the image in any direction, whatever you like. Just like that. So we have two different animation. As you can see, we have slide animation as well as zoom out, but the slide animation is linear right now. So let's make it smoother. Just go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen, and let's make the center animation, which is the displacement, smoother. So what we have to do, just uncheck all the nodes, check the displacement only, click on fit, highlight both the keyframes and create a smooth graph. Just like that. Perfect. Now you can close the spline window, and then you can see here we have nice and smooth animation. Perfect. After that, we have to add one more effect on this image. So select the transform, hit control plus a spacebar for search box, search for CC, which is the color corrector, hit add button, drag and drop to the viewer. Now let's adjust the color of the image or video. So here we have the contrast. Let's set the contrast 1.1. Now it's looking perfect. You can adjust these value according to the image or video that you are using. And then we have to add one more effect, which is the Gaussian blur. So hit control plus a spacebar for search box and search for Gaussian blur. So this is the Gaussian blur. Hit add button, drag and drop to the viewer. You can arrange the node just like that. And now let's animate the Gaussian blur. So just go to very first frame of this animation, right click on a strength, click on animate, and just go to frame number 120. Let's set the strength value 0. Now we have the defocus animation as well, which is looking nice. After that, we have to merge the noise texture. So just go to media pool, and this is the fusion clip 2, which is the noise. So just drag and drop on the flow window. Simply you can right click on that, click on rename, or you can also hit F2 to rename. Let's call it noise. Now let's merge the noise with this Gaussian blur. So it's very simple. Connect the output of the noise with the Gaussian blur output, and we will get the new merge. It's very simple way to merge. And now let's drag and drop the merge one to the viewer. Select the merge, and here we have the apply mode. Let's select the linear dodge option, and here we have the blend option, which is the opacity. So I'm going to set the opacity 50%. So let's set the blend value 0.5. Let me tell you one thing, I have created this noise and the stroke effect inside of After Effects because in DaVinci Resolve, we don't have any tool to create this type of effect. So I hope you understand. After that, let's merge the stroke. So this is the Fusion Clip 3, which is the stroke. Let's drag and drop on the flow window, hit F2 on the keyboard to rename. And this is the stroke. So let's call it stroke, hit OK. Let's connect the output of this stroke with the main output. And as you can see, we have this type of stroke effect. Select the merge, go to the apply mode, and change this to screen mode. And finally, we have something like this. You can close the media pool, and after that, let's create a random polygon shape. So what we have to do, so this is the background. Let's drag and drop the background on the flow window, hit F2 on the keyboard. I'm going to use this background as a mat, so let's call it mat. Let's attach the polygon with this mat, just like that. Select the polygon and remove the automatic keyframe. Hit control and scroll up to zoom in. And let's start from here. So hold shift on the keyboard and create this type of polygon. So this is the polygon. Now let's animate the polygon. So just go to on frame number 180, which is equal to 3 seconds. Right click on this text, click on animate, and just go to very first frame of this animation. Highlight all the control points, hold shift and drag it to the left hand side. And then let's arrange these control points as well. So as you can see, we have a linear animation. Let's make it smoother. Just go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard to full screen, increase the size of the spline window, and this time we have to create a smooth animation for the polygon 2 only. So click on fit button, highlight both the keyframes, hit S to smooth, and create a smooth graph just like that. Close the spline window. Now you can see here we have a smooth animation. Now I want to place this image inside of this black section, so it's very simple. We have to take a new merge node. So I'm gonna use this black mat as a background, so connect the yellow background point with this mat, and I'm gonna use this output as a foreground, so connect the green point with this merge, and this is the merge 3. Let's drag and drop to the viewer. Alright, now select the merge 3, go to operator, and here we have to change over to in. Now we have this type of effect, as you can see. Now let's merge this output with the background. So it's very simple again. This is the white background, placed it over here. Connect the foreground with the background and we will get the new merge. Let's drag and drop the merge 4 to the viewer. And after that, let's add some text to the scene. So it's very simple again. Let's create a text node. Connect the text output with the main, and this is the new merge. Let's drag and drop to the viewer. Select the text and type a number first. For example, this is the slide 1, so let's call it 01. Select your favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using Baby's New Pro. Select the style middle. Let's increase the size of the text, maybe 0.14, and place the text right over here. After that, let's animate the opacity of the text. So just go to frame number 180. Go to setting, and here we have the opacity. So right click on opacity, click on animate. Just go to frame number 60, which is equal to 1 second, and set the opacity 0. And we will get this type of opacity animation on the text. Finally, let's create one more text for the description over here. So select the text, hit Ctrl C to copy, hit Ctrl V to paste, connect the text with the main output, drag and drop to the viewer. For the second text, let's change the color to black. Now let's type description over here. Now let's down the size of the text, maybe 0.03. Let's align it to the left hand side, and then you can place the text right over here in this corner. Alright, and now let's change the animation. So first of all, we have to remove the opacity animation. Just go to setting, right click on opacity, click on remove text 1 opacity. Alright, and then just go to text, and here we have to animate the write on parameter. So just go to frame number 180, right click on end, click on animate, go to frame number 90, let's set the end value 0. And we will get this type of effect, as you can see. Now let's create a duplicate of the text. Simply select the text, hit Ctrl C, hit Ctrl V, and connect this third text with the main output, drag and drop to the viewer. Select the text and type your Instagram username or whatever you like, just like that. Now you can increase the tracking amount. So I'm going to set the tracking amount 1.05, and then you can place the text in this corner, just like that. And after that, let's create one more copy. So hit Ctrl V on the keyboard, connect the text with the main output, drag and drop to the viewer. This time we have to type our website or any other detail, whatever you like. Align it to the right hand side. Let's select the white color, and this is the text. Let's place the text over here. You can increase the tracking amount 1.05. Perfect. And then we have to create the main text. So for the main text, let's create a new text node. Attach the text with this main output, drag and drop to the viewer. Now let's type your first line here. Select the black color, select your favorite font style. Let's increase the size. I'm gonna set the value 0.12, and let's align it to the left hand side and place the text right over here maybe. Perfect. Now let's create a duplicate of the text. So hit Ctrl C to copy, hit Ctrl V to paste, connect the second text with the main output, drag and drop to the viewer. And now let's type your second line, just like that. Drag and drop over here. You can change the style to regular, And finally, we have to animate the text. So let's select the first line first. Just go to frame number 180, go to layout, right click on center, click on animate and lock the position as it is. Do the same thing for the second line. And then select the first line, go to frame number 30, and let's drag and drop the text outside of the frame. And just go to frame number 60, select the second line and drag and drop outside of the frame. Now we will get this type of parallax kind of a effect. And then just go to spline window, hit F4 on the keyboard. This time uncheck all the text node and check the text 2 and 2_1. All right, click on fit button, highlight all the keyframes, hit S to smooth. Just set the CDI at very beginning of this animation, hold this handle and create a nice smooth curve as you all know. Perfect. And close the spline window. Here it is almost ready, so click on fit button and you can see here it's looking like this. Now you can connect the media out node with the main output just like that, and then go to the edit page, and here we have our first slideshow animation. Now let me show you how you can create multiple slides. So simply select the slide one, hit Ctrl C to copy, hit Ctrl V to paste. For this one I want to use a video clip, so we have to import the video clip. Just go to the media pool, right click on that, click on import media, and this is the video clip that I have downloaded from pixels.com, and I will give you a link in the description. Just open the video clip. You can use any video clip that you like. First of all, we have to match the size and the frame rate of the video clip according to the project setting. So just drag and drop the video clip on the timeline. Match the duration of the video clip. Size is perfect. Then right click on that, click on new fusion clip. You can remove the video clip from the timeline. Place the CDI on the second slide, go to fusion page, and here we have to replace the image with the video. So this is the image. Simply delete the image, and this is the fusion clip 4, which is the video clip. Drag and drop the video clip and connect this with the transform. All right, it's done. Now you can customize everything whatever you like. So first of all, I want to change the number. So this is the text one. Let's type 02 and let's change the main text. So select the first line, type anything whatever you like, just like that, and then you can go to the edit page, and here we have the second slide. Now you can overlap the slide for 1 second. So just go to 5 seconds, drag and drop the second fusion clip and place it over here just like that. Now you can get this type of transition. Just go to very first frame of this animation, turn on the loop button, hit Ctrl F to full screen, and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this video. I hope you like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos, and also hit the like button for this video. My name is Vikash and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.